just 30 goals for the entire season. I say just 30 because this is a guy that could probably easily score 50 in his sleep. Yet you look at his 5-on-5 goals the last three seasons, 21, 22, and then a down year by his standards at just 13. So, Mike, I turn to you. Three steps to get Patrik Laine going again, scoring again. 5v5, how does he do it?
Yeah, more consistently. It is a three-pronged approach. If I was with the Winnipeg Jets or working with Patrik and his group, this is what I would present to them in terms of how you get that consistency level up. Number one, a research project I've been working on, shot optimization. Are you taking shots from the areas that you score from? And if not, how do we clean that up? Number two, he needs new line mates. Brian Little at center has not worked with Patrik Laine. We are going to show you who we should be playing with to get him optimal results, get him into those better shooting areas. And number three, ultimately, I think what this comes down to for the Jets, they need a left shot center as their number two centerman. They don't have that right now. So let's focus on number one, first of all, with Patrik Laine. He scores almost 60% of his goals from that outer slot area, the inner slot right in front of the net, high danger area. This is the outer slot. You got to have a good shot to score from here. He does it at volume at 5-on-5, almost 60% of his goals. He takes 39% of his shot attempts from here, though. You want those numbers to be closer together. Ideally, you are getting to your scoring area as much as you're scoring from there. This is the above the faceoff circle zone, where he has only scored 4% of his goals. He is taking a disproportionate amount of his shot attempts from here, almost a third of his shot attempts. Now, if that isn't telling enough, let's show you the raw totals. In the last 3 years at 5-on-5, 232 shot attempts, he scored twice from there. He should not be shooting from there. He should be getting to that outer slot area more often. So how do you do it? He's deadly off the rush, and he needs somebody who can find him in zone. Off the rush, you put him with Nick Ehlers, the best transition player on the Winnipeg Jets, who he has not played with regularly since his rookie season. But Ehlers can whip the puck up the ice with his skating ability through the neutral zone. That can help Laine generate a little more from that high danger outer slot area. As for in-zone offense, how do you find him in that outer slot area with more regularity? You put him with the best passer on the team and one of the best in the business, Blake Wheeler. Now, yes, this is splitting up Scheifele and Wheeler. I think the Jets need to do this anyways if they want to be a more balanced team. You've got Roslovic top line right wing. Now you've got Ehlers the speed threat, Wheeler the in-zone facilitator of the puck, and Laine a guy who can find better spots to get open. Ultimately, like I said, I think part of the problem with Laine as well is the fact that with these right shot centers that the zone kind of gets cut off, cut in half for him a little bit at times. If you had a left shot center, that's more ideal. But I think that these are the steps that the Winnipeg Jets and Patrik need to take if he wants to get into the conversation of a 45-50 goal guy and score more at 5-on-5.
Yeah. And to me, it's really crystal clear. But the fact of the matter is, when you know the players and their personalities in the National Hockey League, Wheeler and Scheifele absolutely pine to play with each other all the time. They expect to be playing with each other. They may even take it farther than you can imagine. It's not in the best interest of the Winnipeg Jets. Paul Maurice, Kevin Cheveldayoff, they need to step in a situation like that and no longer play those guys together. Instead, separate them, competing. Neither one of them really has shown a propensity from a public standpoint to want to play with Patrik Laine. That's just a fact of the matter, and this is some hard talk here, but this is what happens behind closed doors. Until they separate those two players, allow Laine to play with somebody that fits his look a little more, I think it's going to be problematic for the Winnipeg Jets. And it's a shame. I've never seen a young player as good as Patrik Laine have more challenges in terms of how he's fit in with his team. We could say it's him. We could say it's the team. We could say it's the coach. Mm-hmm. It doesn't matter. Now you need to problem solve. And to me, that's clearly the biggest thing that this information would be telling me if I were general manager of the Winnipeg Jets.
Are you guys finding situations nowadays where GMs and coaches are more approachable and open and receptive to this type of data to say, okay, we really should make a shakeup here? It's not passing the eyeball test.
Oh, well, you know, right now, obviously, the Winnipeg Jets, you know, they're working on signing key players, so that's still going on. But the fact of the matter is that, yes, this is part of your role as a general manager. This is part of your role as a head coach, to figure out the best combinations of players and to do it in a world where people's feelings, they still matter.
Yeah.
You got to figure out a way to manage that. And if you want to be an elite team like the Winnipeg Jets have the possibility to be, everything has to go right.